Good morning, students. I am Sonia Augustine and I will be teaching English today for grade 5. Okay, students, I hope you must have liked the first poem which you learned previously. So today we are going to start the second lesson, that is daydreams. Now every one of you likes to dream. Sometimes you have dreams which are scary. Sometimes you have dreams which are very beautiful. And sometimes you dream even when you are not actually sleeping. What do you mean by daydreams? Daydreams are the thoughts or the things which come to your mind when you're actually not sleeping. For example, sometimes when the teacher is teaching you in the classroom, you suddenly go into another world. Maybe the teacher is teaching you science and then you start thinking about what would you be doing when you go home. In case you have to attend a party, the whole time you will be thinking what you would be doing, when will you go, what will you wear, all those kind of thoughts. These thoughts are called as daydreams. Not necessarily it may come true, but it's just the thought that comes into one's mind. This is a very beautiful lesson which tells you about daydreams. If you look to your page 2, you will see how wonderfully the pictures are displayed. So we'll quickly go through the lesson and then you'll understand much better what does it mean to daydream. So all of you, open your textbooks and as I'm reading, pay attention. Once there lived a couple who spent a lot of time in idle talk. So in the picture, very beautifully displayed, you can see the two of them very happily sitting. Maybe the farmer has finished his work and maybe in the evening he and his wife are having a great time talking about what happened during the day. Like how when you all come back home from school, you have so many things to tell your parents. You tell them how the school was, what did you do, what did the teachers teach you. And in the same way, these two would sit and spend a lot of time in idle talk. What do you mean by idle talk, students? Idle talk is something which may not be relevant, but you know, you just keep talking about it. Sometimes maybe it has got nothing to do with you, but still you just enjoy talking about that particular thing and spending your time. So these two would sit and they would keep on talking and talking and talking and talking, and the time would pass by. One day the husband said, "I have always wanted to keep cows. If by chance I get some extra money from somewhere, I am going to buy a few cows." Now as these two were discussing about the various things, the husband suddenly has a desire, a thought. And what is that thought about, students? He wanted to keep cows. Now all of you know, cow is such a useful animal and it's very, very important because it gives us milk. So the farmer wanted to keep cows and he said that if I get some extra money from somewhere, I am going to buy a few cows. So here we can understand that the farmer wanted extra money. Maybe they were not very rich, so he was waiting to collect some money so that he could buy a few cows that would help him. But that means a lot of work. You have to feed the cows, walk them, bathe them, milk them. Cows need a lot of looking after. Now, the moment the wife hears about this, she starts thinking that, oh my God, if the farmer is going to get cows, there's going to be extra work. Like you very well know, students, in case you have a pet at home, if it's a dog, it's a cat, it's a bird, whatever, you have to take a lot of care. You cannot just get an animal at home and just keep it like that. Like if you, for example, if you have a dog, you have to take it for a round, you have to bathe it, you have to give the special food, and you have to take care of it, because when you have, it's like an extra member of the family. You can't just leave it. In the same way, the moment the wife hears that the farmer is going to get a cow, she gets all very panicked and she thinks, who will do all the work? Because according to her, you have to feed the cows, you have to take them for a walk, you have to bathe them, milk them, and you have to look after them. One cow would be enough. There is no need to buy more cows, said the wife. So now you can see what the wife says. She's like, one is enough. The farmer is talking about cows. She says, one cow is more than enough. So maybe she meant that if we have one cow, we will take care of that one. And then maybe once we get used to it, we can go and get more cows. But for the time being, one would be enough for her. But think of all the milk we'll get if we buy more, said the husband. So now the husband was all ready to buy cows. He wasn't interested to buy just one. He said, think about the milk, because the more cows, the more milk. The husband's entire interest was to get more milk. He didn't think about the bathing, walking, eating part. What he wanted was milk. That's true. The wife agreed. Now, when he talked about the milk, even the wife became very happy. She said, oh my God, wow, it would be so nice. And you can see in the picture alongside how the farmer is thinking and daydreaming about having so many cows, and where he's happily milking all the cows. There will be so much of milk that we can have plenty of dahi and butter and ghee. Wouldn't it be lovely? So you all know, when there is milk in the house, even your parents or your mom must be preparing dahi, then butter, which is all very tasty. So that was a lot of good things would be there if the cow would be bought. How lucky that I have all these earthen pots kept aside. See, students, there's a picture there which shows you about the earthen pots. I'll use one of the pots for milk, one for dahi, one for butter. The ghee I'll put in another jar, and I'll use this remaining pot to send milk to my sister. So now the wife also started talking like the husband. She's like, okay, now she's also daydreaming, all right? And she's planning. She's like, I'm going to keep one pot for milk, one for dahi, one for butter, and the ghee I'll put in another jar. And not only that, she even thinks to send the remaining milk to her sister. Look at how these people have formed their dreams. So now you have the cows in their mind, you have the pots, and you have what they are even going to do with the remaining milk. So students, for today we will read till here only. So I expect you to read till where we have done, until the next class. It's better if you try to read the whole lesson, and we'll be doing it in the next class. Thank you. Stay safe.